just like Gambit said, man, once they take these hitches out of the jump shot, like when you catch the ball, you can actually just go up with it and the servers get more stable. People are going to swear that they did something to shoot him, but no, it's just going to be that the game is running smoother. And, you know, that's where we are with it, man.
Hey, guys, it's LJ. Make sure you like the video and subscribe for more great content for my daddy.
Good evening out there in 2K land, man. Check this out, man. So it all started with this build right here, man. I was playing with this young man, what his name? To the Tap, man. Look, man, hey, I ain't gonna lie, bro. He was hooping, bro. He had, this was his build. And I was like, I had to go check it out afterwards, man. He was hitting shots. He was blocking shots. Like, he was snatching people out of the air when they tried to dunk on him and everything, man. So I figured, hey, man, I might as well share this build with y'all, man, because this was a good build. And somehow he had, he got 80 speed, 79 agility, 85. Yeah, I wish he would have had 85 strength or whatever. But this might be a build I might have to make. Now I'm going to have to put more rebounding on my guy. And I'm probably going to bring that pass act down and some stuff like that, man. And maybe not no 88 midi and stuff like that. Definitely not 88, 87 driving dunk. But hey, my man put together a nice build, man, and I just wanted to celebrate him, man, because if we gonna bang on, bag on people when they don't do good, hey, we gotta celebrate people when they do, man. So, hey, with all that said, let's just get right into the video. Yes, sir! What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, J-Eazy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Town, coming to you live with another video, man. We ain't got too much for y'all tonight, man. It just seems that there's an overwhelming, like, the shot stick might be the most polarizing thing in the 2K community right now, just shooting and all that, man. And people just, I don't know if they don't want to do it, they don't want to adapt to it, they don't want to go over to it. But I've seen this three times before, man. I saw it in 2K17, I saw it in 2K21 current, and then I'm seeing it now, and it's just like, bro, it's one of them things where you either got to get right or get left, man. Look at this right here. This is what you can do with the shot stick if you become proficient at timing it. But the thing is, you're gonna have to do two things. You gotta get a jump shot that's something that you can actually shoot with the shot stick, right? And then you gotta get your timings right. So you gotta release the stick when it's up here, when it gets to the set point or whatever point you want, and then you have to flick the stick up at the speed of your guy's release or his hand or whatever, which changes with every single shot. So a lot of people think that it's easy, but to those people that think it's easy, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Bro, if it was that easy, everybody would do it. Now, a lot of people are doing it because it is a lot more consistent. It does help you and all that. We're gonna talk about all of that. But before we get started, make sure y'all like the video and comment y'all thoughts down below, because y'all already know we're trying to go with this thing to the moon, Alice. And if nobody told y'all this today, y'all, my brothers, my sisters, my family, love each and every last one of y'all. Check that boy got going, market dog going to the rim, man. But check this out. Speaking of the polarizing this, a job Bridge Forth, he says, hey, players are reporting that shooting was allegedly touched recently. Anyone else notice players greening more consistently? Nope. People been chicked from the beginning. That's why I kept telling y'all, if they change shooting, then everybody's gonna be hitting, bro. When I'm in here and I'm playing with fellow reds and goals, bro, everybody in here is chicked. It's like everybody's hitting shots. So I mean, people could have gotten better at the same time. A lot of people may have just figured it out at the same time, but like maybe y'all are just now getting out there in the field and playing, man. But bro, from what I've been seeing, dude, well, people been hitting jumpers since the beginning of the game. And like, I think it's just been a skill gap issue, but hey, they just said, hey, 100% touch already sneakily. Cause I've been seeing some of the most efficient shooting the past couple of days. Bro, I've been seeing this since the beginning. Me and T was like, bro, where are the people that are missing? Because I ain't seen nobody that's really missing like that. And he says, hey, I swear this stuff yesterday, everybody starting to be knocked down. Nah, people been knocked down before that, because Thunder was talking about last week, bro, you can't leave nobody open no more. And then he says, hey, unless everybody figured out shooting at the same time. And then Gilly says, they definitely tested, which isn't a bad thing, but the shooting system as a whole, it's still dog poop. I'm not sure that they can repair it. Just dumb game logic or whatever. He says servers have been better. I could believe that. And just like Gambit said, man, once they take these hitches out of the jump shot, like when you catch the ball, you can actually just go up with it and the servers get more stable. People are going to swear that they did something to shoot him, but no, it's just going to be that the game is running smoother. And you know, that's where we are with it, man. But hey, and dude said, hey, we've had some hot fixes. Go to the menu at night for the last couple of days. So 2K might have improved the stability for shooting shot to shot because all of a flak they are getting for all of the flack they're getting for RNG. I don't think it is, man. I think people have just gotten better, have gotten used to it, have realized that this is the system that it's going to be, and this is what people gonna go with, man. And it just is what it is. I, like I said, I never ran into the people on this game that we could just leave open. Even the first day we were playing in Old Town, bro, we never been able to leave people open. We've been in the wreck, we've been in the proving ground. If you cheat off somebody, you step down, they was gonna light you up. That was just it. It just was what it was. So I don't know when people were playing people that you could just leave open, but hey, for me and mine, hey, you better get out there and guard your man, because if you don't, you're gonna get lit up. Hey, up next, JobRizz4 says, hey, the button and the stick are both two inputs, which is complete and utter horse shit. But I understand what he's trying to do. He's just trying to get engaged, man. I ain't mad at him. He says, hey, the button to start the jump shot, down and then up to let the ball go. This is the funniest thing I've seen all day, man. Then he says, the stick down and then up to let the ball go. Am I missing something? And then he says, hey, but it's new, so it's skill or what have you. And he says, yes, you are missing something. He says, what am I missing? The stick is the stick more than two inputs? And he says, you're confused as to what input means. Rhythm you have to have the speed and the tempo. X, you just release the button. He says, still doesn't make sense to me, but whatever, I'm gonna use the rhythm stick because it's because shooting is easier. And then my man says, the difference between the button and the stick is the speed at which you go up to let go of the ball matters. The stick speed of input to release matters. Button speed of input to release doesn't matter. Exactly. So you don't, and that's why you have a bigger green window with that, because they have to give you some time to get off of the button, because like they do say it's a 70% bigger green window or whatever, which is true, but it's only because the time that it would take, and y'all already see me in that corner, man. Y'all know what I was gonna do, man. I'm pulling that thing, tray ball. Bang, bang. Hey, so the time that it takes to get off the button is minuscule. But when you're shooting the shot with the stick, you have to go from here, and then you have to go from here to here. So you got dead zones. It's going to take some time to go from here to here for it to know that it's dead, that you're off of the button. And then it's gonna take some time for you to go up at a certain speed or what have you. So the green window has to be bigger, because from here to here takes more time than just pressing the depressing and releasing the button. So I get why the green zone is bigger, because otherwise I don't think you'd be able to hit it and enter two inputs at the very same time. But hey, I digress, man. It is what it is. Believe what you want to believe, but we know what it is, man. We know you're just doing it for engagement. I ain't mad at you, big dog. You can do what you do. I agree with it 110%, man. Up next, hey, my man says it's easier to green with this was the same thing JobRizz4 says, it's easier to green with the rhythm stick than the button, because the stick has a 70% bigger green window, so does it really take more skill over the button? Yeah, it does. And the reason that it does is because, again, what we said, the speed at which you move the stick up matters. Yes, it's easier to green, because a lot of times what you're gonna do is you're gonna get a green, but you're gonna screw up the tempo, because the tempo has to go at the speed of the hand, and the speed of the hand is different a lot, unless you have a very consistent jump shot or something like that. But the speed of the hand, it can change a lot. A lot of times it doesn't matter if I'm defended or not, I'm gonna get an excellent, but I'll blow the tempo or something like that, man. So I get what he's saying, but you know, you gotta stir up the community or something, man. You gotta stir up the community, man. I ain't even mad at you, bro. You gotta do what you gotta dozzle. And he says, hey, anybody using the stick shooting better, save for what the new controller, that stick drift is gonna slap at the end. I don't know, man. I got the optical joints on mine, and I can take my, I got that, and then I got the Victrix Gambit or whatever, and I got another controller. I can just completely take my sticks out, so pause, so I don't have to worry about that. But yeah, I feel what y'all saying, man. It's the it's the Thrustmaster Supreme controller. So hold on, man, let me get my stuff going, man. You're gonna need that. Dang, did I just do all that right here? I just messed it all up, didn't I, man? It's supposed to be here, right? And then it's supposed to be that, and then that. Thrustmaster controller. Pause, man. You get one of those, you ain't gotta worry about stick drift, man. But hey, it is what it is. You can miss shots, so you get stick drift. Hey, every controller gonna mess up eventually, man. So that's just how it goes, man. Make sure I don't sound weird or nothing like that, man. I think I do sound a little weird, but hey, we back to it, man. He said, hey, I don't even use the rhythm stick but use the stick. And my personal preference is to, it just feels smoother to me. I'm gonna tell y'all one thing, man. If you play defense on this game, you're gonna move your right stick and you're gonna get stick drift, I guess. So, I mean, yeah, it is what it is, man. Hey, this is what my boy Downward said about it. Guy who actually makes the game. Players who use the rhythm shooting will have a significant advantage over regular button shooters. People, nah. Then he says, 2K layups. Player who use the rhythm stick will have a significant advantage over the button shooters. Time to learn the rhythm stick. That's what I'm talking about, Dad. Rhythm shooting has a delay on the catch and shoot. That stuff isn't natural. I don't know what the percentages is on that. It happens every now and then, man. There are some steps that you can do to mitigate that a little bit, but yeah, it does happen, and sometimes it is discouraging. And then they said 2K layout don't lie to us every year and stuff like that. There is a delay on the rhythm stick or what have you, and it will happen. But this is what my boy, y'all already saw me at the beginning of the thing, and he said this is how confident he is with the rhythm stick. You see the fella closing out. Once you learn how to do it, he's already up. In this game, when you already start your shot, they can't really contest you anymore. So it's up to you to just do it, because this is probably going to just say open. Oh, it said tight coverage. Where was he when he shot it? When he began his upward motion, oh, he was there when he began that upward motion. He was about right here when he began his upward motion. But really, he's already saying, it's already red when he began his upward motion, is what I'm saying. And then he takes the shot. He's there, falls over. And, yo, he still hit the shot, man. The reason he still hit the shot because, hey, rhythm shooting. And, you, like I said, you definitely got to time that joint, because if you don't, you're going to smoke that joint, man. And so somebody definitely asked this right here. And I think... somebody definitely asked this to my guy Dime Work, man. He was talking about the delay or what have you. He just says, hey, he said most wouldn't mind using the stick if it wasn't delayed. And he says it gets a delay from time to time. Not a deal breaker for me, though. And that's what I say, man. Like I said, it's not a deal breaker for me, because like right here, you can see I get the delay. Well, I didn't get the delay right there. So you can see that that you can shoot right off the bat most of the time. But it really depends on wherever you catch the ball. If you catch the ball low and he takes it on down, then you'll be able to just go ahead and shoot it. But sometimes sometimes you just can't shoot it, and he'll sit there and hold the ball and you'll blow a shot or something like that, and it'll just be bad, man. And so like I said, I don't know if y'all guys are button shooters or stick shooters, but I'm just like, bro, if one isn't working, why not try the other one? That's all I'm saying. Like, it doesn't matter if what you using ain't like nobody can come see you. Like, most people using Zens out there, like, it really doesn't matter. If you're smoking jump shots and you're completing utter ass and your point guard is fussing at you and stuff, you might as well just try to use the rhythm stick and see if that helps you out any. And if it does, it does. If it does not, then it doesn't. But you know, just do what works for you. And if you're a button shooter, then be a button shooter. I mean, no, I don't think anybody's mad at it. I definitely am not. So it is what it is. Up next, Chalk says, hey, if 2K25 didn't have skill-based matchmaking, it would go down as one of the best. I agree with you. He said, Chalk, no BS. I love the skill-based matchmaking. Last night played a five in rec, and it was close, fun, competitive, lost, and wasn't even mad. This year is better. It's the better 2Ks in memory. And he says, hey, I appreciate that you're a real person typing this. I too enjoy playing competitive matches, but I think there's a place for it. I don't think that I should have to sweat in theater. And that's right. Not only do we got to sweat in theater, man, he just said, oh yeah, for sure. I think at this point in 2K, we all know casual theater, park, whatever, you know, stuff like that. So like I said, man, to me, I really don't care about none of it. They can leave it competitive. They can do it like that. I'm not ducking competition. The problem is, y'all saw me sit there for like 30 minutes yesterday, bro, trying to get a game, and I wasn't able to get a game, and people not even sympathetic toward that. That's all. I just want to get a game. I don't care about who I play or whatever, because I'm actually trying to get better at the game. So if I'm playing people on my level or higher, then that means that I have the opportunity to get better. So every time I get on this joint, I'm going after the opportunity to get better, but not everybody is doing that. And that's fine. You don't have to try to get better every time you touch the game, because some people don't care to get better, and that is okay. Some people just want to sit here and casually play the game. That is completely and utterly fine. That's what I want most of the time. But when I come into the theater, I go into the rec, especially for the solo modes, keep the skill-based matchmaking in, because you do want to get competent teammates. You don't want to get teammates that are that way you're matched up and you're just completely overmatched. You want to have games where you're able to compete. So when you go in a random wreck and you get people on your level, I think that's dope. But at the same time, you do run into some situations. You do run into some situations sometimes where like it's trying to find you teammates and you just don't have an opportunity to play. I don't have that much time. We want to go in the theater and just run so we can have fun. And you know, I don't care about sweating in theater. I'm cool with that. But I just want to play somebody, you know, get my team, play somebody and see what's going on, man. So I can get this. Maybe I want to just try out a new jump shot. Maybe I want to just try out a new build and, you know, stuff like that, man. So, I mean, that's what I think, man. I don't know what anybody else thinks or how anybody else feels about it. But for me, I enjoy playing the game. It doesn't matter who against whom I'm playing. I just like playing the game and having fun, man. So let me know what y'all think down in the comment section though, man, because like I said, it could be completely different for you guys. Do you guys have to wait an hour between games and stuff like that, like I had to almost yesterday? Or like my first game, they'll get me into pretty quickly, but as soon as I finish that first game, then it's waiting. And sometimes they will, and sometimes the game won't even start, man. So let me know what y'all think down in the comment section, man. Is it too much, too little, too late? What is it, man? And then we're gonna fast forward to the end of this game, and I don't know if we won or lost, but hold on. We did win, so y'all can see what happened here at the end. It was just 18-18, and my boy, he just went to the corner and faded that thing, tray ball with the button. And he said, bang, bang. So it is what it is, man. Let me know what y'all think down in the comment section. Do y'all like the shooting? Do y'all button shoot? Do you rhythm shoot? Do you think that shooting got easier all of a sudden? Or you think that people just got better? I think people just got better, man. So let me know what y'all think down in the comment section. I'll holler at y'all next time. Till next time. It's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Town. Godspeed.